I'd like to invite Srinivas Kodali, an independent researcher who's going to tell us a bit about NPR and Aadhaar today. We will have Srinivas tell us a story of where it all began and how we got here to NPR, Aadhaar, the databasing of citizens. Srinivas.
The story of NPR has a strong bond to Bombay. It all began here. If you ask me what is NPR, if you really want to know what NPR is, you must go and talk to your own fishermen and why NPR came in. They'll tell you much better than any other researcher, any other government bureaucrat can tell you. Because it all began with the Bombay attacks. Or that's when it started getting implemented. If you go back to the history of it, everyone's going to tell you it started with the Kargill War. The reason it started in the Kargill War is Kargill War, there were Pakistani army men who entered India in civilian clothes. There was an intelligence failure by the Indian army which couldn't identify Indians and foreigners. So what you have post the Kargill War is there was a Kargill War Review Committee which suggested that, okay, we need to do a bunch of things so that India is secure and we don't have a repeat of war like Kargill. One of the suggestions was to implement what was called the National Population Register. It's essentially you identify every Indian so that when you come across some stranger on the streets, you know he's not an Indian because he's not in your database. Along with the National Population Register, what was supposed to be done is issue identity cards to Indians because there were no national identity cards at that point of time. It was 1999, Kargill. So what you bring up, something called the Multipurpose National ID Card, MNIC. So you bring this card because that was the most efficient way of identifying at that point of time. It was a smart card. It was based on something called a SOXTA standard, S-E-O-S-T-A, which was based on an ISO standard for your chip cards. The most equivalent that you have is your driver's license with a chip. If you have your driver's license with a chip card in it, that's the card that they were issuing. And the reason this card was being issued was because it can't be duplicated. Most IDs could be duplicated. So you want to verify identity cards. So what you do is you put a chip in it and you put information in it. And the army or anyone, a bunch of the national security agencies can read it. Right? So this was the multipurpose national ID card. And they adopted this because this was the strongest ID system at that point of time, which came out because the Ministry of Road Transport said, we need to have smart IDs where people cannot duplicate driver licenses. So there are a lot of technical details on why certain things happen. Even though the project was recommended by the Kargill War Review Committee, it never got implemented. There are a bunch of trials or pilots which happened because it was a technical system. You had to implement it across the country. So you had to do test runs. You had to teach your bureaucrats how to implement it, how to spread it across the country. So it took a while. And to do that, you had to amend your laws. So what you do, the first thing is the Citizenship Act was amended in 2003, post-Kargill. Then you got the citizenship rules under which the National Population Register was going to be carried out. Post that, the trials or the pilots happened. They happened, I mean, there was change of government, the Vajpayee government lost power. You had the Congress government come in. Even the Congress did pilots in 2006, and the latest pilot was in March of 2008. Okay, and you have Bombay attacks in November of 2008. This is where it gets interesting. Bombay attacks was failure in multiple levels, right? So you see Pakistani terrorist hijacking an Indian fishing vessel off the coast of Gujarat, entering into Bombay, posing as Indian fishermen. Identity crisis, we couldn't identify them. The Coast Guard couldn't, the Indian Navy couldn't, the Indian police couldn't. So what do you do? Oh, we have a project called the National Population Register, and we have something called the Multipurpose National ID Card. Let's start implementing it. So which is why you get the NPR project, which was notified in 2010, part of the census of 2011. It took them time to design and scale it, but they started implementing it right away in the coast of Bombay. And it's important to understand the geopolitical significance of this, because this was a new threat vector for India. Coasts suddenly became a threat. And there were multiple committees and hearings that happened post-Bombay attacks. You had the coastal committee at the parliament, which brought its own review of what should be done. So you got coastal police stations. You wanted to link all of those police stations. So you built something called the crime and criminal numbering tracking system. Then during the Bombay attacks, the Indian intelligence agencies did not know that the Pakistani terrorists were in contact with their handlers in Pakistan. They couldn't intercept it. So what you get something called the central monitoring system, which would enable the Indian intelligence agencies to listen to anything over Indian telecom infrastructure, SMSs, phone calls. So you had a bunch of things which came up. One interesting thing that came out of this is India suddenly realized we were not registering fishing vessels. So we didn't know if it was an Indian fishing vessel or a Pakistani or a Sri Lankan or a Bangladeshi fishing vessel. So you start building a database for fishing vessels like you do for cars. So Bombay attacks is where everything starts or starts getting implemented. But then again, you have Aadhaar. There is a reason why Aadhaar comes in. It wasn't like it was a new thing. There was something called the EPDS project, or an Electronic Public Distribution System project, which was supposed to be implemented with grants by the World Bank in 2006. And there was something called the National E-Governance Plan, which is recommending a host of things, including a unique ID. As I was saying, the NPR project goes back to Kargill. It was always there. It was always part of the Indian government's plan to digitize governance. What Bombay attacks did, it just enabled the government. It gave them a reason to push it. And there were no questions asked, because it was being done for national security. And if you ask me, what is the relationship between Aadhaar and NPR? So I told you about the smart card, right? There was a problem with the smart card. Part of NPR, or the part of the multipurpose national ID card, your fingerprints were collected. So when you go even now to get a driver's license, your thumb fingerprints are collected, not all the 10, because you can't store all the 10 fingerprints in that chip. There's not enough technical memory. Okay, so but there was also one disadvantage. I could go submit my fingerprints as many times as possible, get multiple MNICs. Like you can go get multiple driver licenses in different states. And there's nothing illegal about it. But you couldn't identify if it was being issued to the person the second time. So you needed a central database where you can store all the fingerprints and uniquely identify if this person already had his ID, which is where Aadhaar comes in. And the whole story of welfare is just a ruse. It all came from the national security angle, and multiple people who have been challenging Aadhaar always knew it. There was nothing that Aadhaar or NPR could help welfare with. In fact, it was being used to ensure that all the fishermen queue up in lines so that they can get these ID cards. They have to stop their day's work and get this ID card. Why would they do that? Sure, you have all the technical systems, but you can't spread it. You have to make people queue up, which is what the NRC is. So there are a bunch of things, the politics which happened, there were economic interests. You needed Nandan Nilekani because you couldn't push it. Bureaucracy is slow. There are two ways you can database people in this country. You verify everyone, which is what the NPR was doing under the Ministry of Home Affairs, but it was a very slow exercise. It was supposed to happen from 2001 until 2008. They barely issued few lakhs of ID cards. So you need the private sector for the biometric tech. You need the military tech, actually. We imported a lot.